Hello, one and all. Welcome to the Galaxy Man Show interview show. So for my next guest is this incredible actor from the Arrowverse, known by the name of Falk Henschel. He played the role of Carter Hall, Hawkman. In the Arrowverse, so I'm about to give Falk an add into the live now and have a chat with Falk about his work on Arrow and his other previous projects. So yeah, here we go. Hi, Falk. How's it going?
Hey, bud. How are you?
Yeah, really good. Thanks. It's such a pleasure having you on my show, by the way. It means a lot. To people that don't know who you are, if you can give a bit of backstory about who you are, and then we'll dive right into the questions.
Oh, man. Who am I? That's such a big question. Or not. Well, I'm an actor and filmmaker. I was born in Germany, East Germany. Made my way to the States via London when I was 19. And sort of like entered Hollywood at 27. And I'm probably most known for the role of Hawkman, aka Carter Hall, in the DC Universe.
Awesome. So we'll dive right into the questions now, Falk. So with my very first question, as you mentioned, you played the role of Hawkman, Carter Hall, which was your incredible role in the Arrowverse. What was it like getting to film the two-part crossover in the Arrowverse for Flash and Arrow and making your first appearance as Hawkman? Now, Kendra.
That was fun. I mean, it was also extremely stressful just because, you know, doing the crossovers, you're driving from one show to the next. You shoot out of order, so you don't always, your brain is trying to constantly catch up. Where am I? What am I doing? You're meeting new people. So it's just a wild ride, to be really honest with you. But it was fun. You know, it was just a massive undertaking overall. And we were establishing the characters in Legends while we were doing the crossovers on Flash and Arrow. So we had to, like, you know, make sure that it all lines up with the introduction of the characters and so forth. And it was a whirlwind.
Well, I just have to say, by the way, you played the role of Hawkman incredibly. So I love your performance. With my next question, what was it like working with Stephen Amell and Grant Gustin?
Super fun. I had a little bit more time with Grant. Really nice dude. We ended up doing a little tap together. He came from dancing as a tap dancer, and we connected on that. And really fun atmosphere. And then Steven also seemed like a really nice guy. We had, like I said, less time together, but they were lovely to work with.
Awesome. So on to my very next question. You also went over to Legends of Tomorrow as the role of Hawkman. What was it like forming the Legends team for season one of Legends of Tomorrow? And who did you get along with the most on the Legends set?
Oh, man. By the way, if I seem to slur my words or anything like that, I just had a newborn. So I'm like barely staying up. What was it like to form that team? To be honest, it was really natural. One of my first introductions was actually no team member, but Vandal Savage. Who became a really close friend of mine, Captain Trump. And we just got along. We ended up doing archery together, exploring Vancouver together. So that was really awesome. And so one by one, I met everybody else. I think next was Wentworth Miller, who was lovely. It was just a blast. When else do you get to hang out with a bunch of superheroes?
True. Very, very true. So on to my very next question. What was it like shooting the Vandal Savage arc? Because that was such an incredible arc for season one. Like, season one was such a more... How do I say this? Like, more like a great story arc than other seasons have been with Legends. What was it like shooting the Vandal Savage arc?
I mean, it was a completely different show when I was on it. And that whole Vandal Savage arc was when the show was trying to be linear and sort of tell one big story. It was good. it was good and also kind of hindered a little bit of fun. You know, I think the show has become very fun and very, you know, slapsticky and just a good ride. Because of the arc, I think it was hard to get every character a lot of screen time and, like, really just jump all over. So it was a mixed bag. You know, I really enjoyed it. And at the same time, I wish we just had more time to, like, goof off, you know?
Awesome. So on to my very next question. What was it like playing the possessed Carter Hall, who was, like, brainwashed by Vandal Savage? And what was it like getting to play Evil?
Oh, man. I started my career that way, as a bad guy. So it was kind of back to the roots. I enjoyed it. Bad guys are always fun because, you know, you can kind of do whatever. The audience doesn't have to live through you. So I had a blast playing him.
Awesome. So on to my very next question. When you left the role of Hawkman, what was it like leaving the show of Legends of Tomorrow?
What was it like leaving? It was sudden. And it was never really an official ending for us. I mean, we knew we weren't coming back, or at least so we assumed. But I never felt like the story ever really got wrapped up. And personally, I wish there was some more stuff for the Hawks. I think they're such wonderful characters, and I do think they ended abruptly. And I also think they never really were explored that much. I hope that they get to do that more in the film. I heard they're doing a film. Somebody else will be playing Hawkman, and I wish him so much fun. Because it's just a great character. And I honestly think he was really underexplored in Legends.
That's actually my next question, by the way. If you could come back as Hawkman for Legends of Tomorrow, if they asked you to come back, what next would you like to see from your role as Hawkman?
Before I answer that, where are you from?
I am actually from Australia.
You're from Australia? Are you in Australia right now?
I am, yeah.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
That makes sense. That's why it's sunny. You got summer right now, right?
Yes.
What part of Australia?
Brisbane.
Brisbane, nice.
Yeah.
I've been to Brisbane. I explored the Sunshine Coast, Maroochydore and Noosa and Brisbane. But yes, back to your question was, what would I love to do next? There's like a couple of things that I think could be awesome to be done. One, if it's in the format of the current show, which, like I said, I haven't seen much, but what I saw, it's become very fun and very meta. So I think I'd love to have some fun with Hawkman. I feel like he's been very serious. He's been very, you know, full of gravitas. And I always actually had an instinct and wanted to go a bit more silly with him because he is so old and he has seen so much that I always felt like there was kind of a grumpy disposition to him that could be really fun. Or if we did stay in the sort of more serious world, I always thought it would be fun to do a Hawkman spin-off show set in the medieval times, because I feel like the mace, the armor, the wings fits best in like the times of the knights, you know, like medieval Europe or something like that. And sort of do, you know, do a whole storyline there.
Awesome. So on to my very next question. So with the whole leaving Legends and stuff, when you left Legends as the role of Hawkman, what was it like saying goodbye to the cast members and stuff, and like getting to say goodbye to like the crew and stuff?
Unceremoniously, we shot the big circle where they're at the big dump and they've just finished the mission, and Hawkman sort of like, you know, thank everybody and fly off. We shot that, I think, last. And on a set, you know, you got to go. You're always up against time. And we wrapped that scene. It was my birthday, actually. And that was it. You know, I went to the trailer and, you know, changed. And everybody else had to continue to shoot. So I did my goodbyes. And then I also still had some crossover stuff from Arrow left. And then I came back, you know, so there wasn't really ever, like I said, there wasn't really a, like, it's a wrap. We're done with the story. It was like, okay, it's a wrap. Okay, come back. We might have more of you. And then, you know, yeah, it was unsatisfying.
Awesome. So on to my very next question. I actually let you know, by the way, there was this actually movie that you were in, film called Street Dance 2, that was on TV last night in Australia.
Oh, no way.
What was that experience like, getting to be in Street Dance and playing the role of Ash?
Physically the most challenging role I think I've ever done. We had, the dancing was just insane. We had months, I think 3 months of rehearsals. And then, you know, you film a dance movie, you're spent. It's like the toughest workout ever. No action movie has been as difficult as that film. But again, it was fun. It was my first leading role, so it was a lot of pressure. But also it was a great team, great producers, great directors. It's two of them. Max and Guy and Dania. Yeah, it was fun.
Awesome. So on to my very next question. So you were actually in Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Season 2, and you got to play the role of a Hydra agent who was faking to be kind of a S.H.I.E.L.D. agent. Mm-hmm. What was that experience like getting to play the role of a Hydra agent in Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.?
S.H.I.E.L.D. is done hiding.
Again, I feel like I have the same answer for all of them. Fun. It was fun. I love acting. I love my job. You know, like, you got to know that I actually think working isn't really work. Like, when we get an acting role, by the time that we've done the auditions and the meetings and the all that, by the time you get on set, it's just a blast. So that's like my overall answer for all my jobs. But for Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., it was, again, challenging because we have to do a lot of fighting, a pretty big fight choreography in it with a chain that I've never really worked with before. And it was TV, so we only had a day or so to really, like, practice. And we only had half a day to shoot, whereas on a movie, you know, you have a whole week or two or three to shoot something like that. So challenging, but great fun.
Awesome. So on to my next question. You were actually in this film called Transcendence, and you played the role of Bob back in 2014. Bob. What was that experience like for you?
Transcendence was a bit more challenging. I was going to say fun. It was a part of my career where I was figuring myself out, and there was some hiccups on Transcendence. That's all I'm going to say about Transcendence. But everybody on the set was nice. All the actors were nice. I only briefly interacted with Johnny, but he was very courteous. He seemed very sweet. Loved Paul Bettany. He seems like a great guy. I don't know him that well, but the shoot itself was a bit challenging. We were out in the desert, lots of sandstorms, and a lot of trials.
Awesome. So on to my very next question. You were actually in the film called White House Down, and you played the role of Mott back in 2013. What was that experience like for you?
Damn, you're going through my whole resume.
I have.
White House Down was awesome. Lots of things that got blown up. I got to personally blow up a lot of stuff. it was really fun to work with Roland, who is also German, so we share that in common, and I grew up with his movies. Again, great cast to work with. I got to work with James Woods, who was one of my childhood idols as an actor, and made some good friends and had a great time in Montreal.
Awesome. So on to my very next question, who inspired you as a person to get into acting in the first place?
Man, those are some, there's a few answers to that. I started off because of martial arts. I loved Bruce Lee. I loved Jean-Claude Van Damme. He was one of my heroes. Everybody that's my age will remember that time. Time Cop, Universal Soldier, and Jackie Chan. So I started to do martial arts. And then I actually transitioned into dancing. And so then the idols became Patrick Swayze and Gene Kelly and, actors that were sort of like multi-hyphenates. And all that together then brought me out to LA, and I sort of followed the dance path, actually, and then that led me to acting.
Awesome. So on to my very next question, what have you learned about yourself during COVID this year?
Man, you just did a 180.
I did.
Went from a bunch of movies to the biggest question of the year.
Yep.
Let me just take a break here for 2 seconds. Yep. Hi, Gabrielle. Man, what did I learn from COVID? I mean, I have to honestly say, for me personally, the year has actually been great. I was blessed with a son during COVID. We got pregnant. Well, we found out that we were pregnant right the day before the shutdown, I believe. I got to produce my first feature film with people that I love. So overall, I think the year has been, and I'm in Oregon now, Bend, Oregon, so I'm away from the big city, so I don't get the craziness that some people get. Bless you out there if you're, having a really hard time. I hope you get through this, and sending much love to everybody that is struggling. But regardless, I think it's taught me that we plan too much, or I plan too much, and to stay present, and to just sort of see what's right in front of you. Worry about just today. Are you present with your family? Are you present outside in nature? Are you taking a walk instead of constantly? I do this a lot, constantly spinning of, I got to do this. I got to get the next film. How do I make money? What does this person do? What can I do? All these thoughts. And COVID just kind of showed us that it can all change like that. And we have no idea what the future is going to be like. We still don't, So to sum it up, to stay present.
Awesome. And congratulations for your newborn, by the way. Very congratulations. Do I have kids? No, actually, I'm 25, so not yet, sadly.
My dad was 22 when he had me, so you're not too young, but.
True.
It's fun. If you want some, I can only recommend it. It's tiring in the beginning, or at least in the phase that I'm in, but I'm loving it.
Awesome.
Gives you a nice perspective on everything, and again, brings you in the moment and takes you out of yourself a lot, So nice. Thank you for the congratulations.
You're very welcome. So on to my very next question. If you could be in any TV or movie franchise, what would you want to be in and why?
Oh man, franchise. A franchise. Maybe I'll get to it as we talk about it, but I've actually always been, I'm kind of somebody that isn't too big of a fan of franchises. Not because I don't like franchises. I don't want to diss on franchises, and they're great. And they're successful, they're great. But I come from the days of original stories, one and done, the Braveheart, The Professional, Kramer versus Kramer, Pretty Woman, and that's kind of what got me into acting. So I'm always looking for an original story about characters we don't know, about, a plot we've never heard of. So in a weird way, I look for the opposite of franchises. But if there was a franchise, It would probably be the one that I really tried hard to get was Lord of the Rings, the Amazon TV show.
Yes.
I rode a horse for 2 years, and I went out and dressed up as a ranger in the forest and sent my stuff in, and I didn't get the job yet. Maybe it's still to come. But that franchise would be a dream come true. That's the one that I'd love to do.
Awesome. So on to my very next question, what are the positives and negatives into the acting industry? And how do you get through those negatives as a person?
Say that again. I was just looking at the our audience.
Yes. So what are the positives and negatives into the acting industry? And how do you get through those negatives as a person?
Oh, man. Big things, big questions. Well, the positives are that when it works, it's an amazing job. I get to travel. I get to work with extremely creative and talented people. I get to play with incredible toys. I get to be a kid and pretend to, you know, fly. I get to, you know, play. So, and you get paid well, and you have a lifestyle in which you can explore the world. And you have time for family. So those are all the positives, and they're amazing. The negatives are that it takes just a lot of endurance and a lot of... time to get there. And also, you constantly feel like you never get there. It's always a struggle to get to the next job, or it has been. It's always a question, is your, you know, movie or show successful? Is your character a success? Therefore, do the money people want to invest more in you so that, you know, they can make money by hiring you? And so that part of it, the game, the business of it, is just really draining. You know, it takes a lot of work, which is why I switched to producing, which is also tiring, but you at least have it in your hands and you can work on it rather than sitting there and going, I hope I get another job, twiddling your thumbs. And that might just be me, but personally, that's really hard for me. I've suffered from a lot of depression and self-doubts and, yeah, anxiety, you know, about your self-worth. You know, our industry does a pretty good job to destroy the artist's self-worth. It's just how it's set up. You know, you start out, you're being told that you're not worth anything until you are worth everything. And that's a bit of a mental mind beep. Yeah. Does that answer your question?
Yes, it does. Awesome. So on to my very last question, folks. So what's next for you after COVID-wise?
Is it over?
I don't know. Is it yet? I don't know.
I don't think it is.
Not yet.
I mean, does COVID change? I mean, now that I have a kid especially, I don't know that there is a what's next after COVID. It's sort of like, what's up now? But if COVID should end soon, and even if it doesn't, next for me is finishing up the film that I produced this year and starred in. It's a comedy. It's my first venture into a fantastical comedy. It's a body swap movie. And we're in the edit. We're finishing it up. And then I'm going to explore the whole world of selling a film and hopefully bringing it to you guys. And then we'll find out. Hopefully produce another film. Maybe act in somebody's film again. Who knows? Most of all, make sure that my son grows up healthy and that he gets to play and that hopefully we play together. Hopefully movies too. I don't want to pressure him, but it'd be really awesome.
Awesome. Well, can I just say thank you so much, Falk. It's been such a pleasure having you on my show.
You.
The people that haven't seen Falk's work, he's such an incredible actor and one inspirational person in life. So, Falk, never stop being you. Any last final thoughts or anything that you'd like to say to people?
Yes. With everything that's going on, be good to yourself. Don't beat yourself up. Take care of yourself. Make sure that you're healthy, be kind to yourself, and then I think you can automatically, or then that helps you deal with the rest of the world. Just really, really take care of yourselves out there. It's not easy times right now.